थैंक यू प्रदीप कुमार जी,
गुड आफ्टरनून।
गुड आफ्टरनून टू यू एंड मोस्ट वेलकम टू द कॉटन गुरु शो एंड वेरी वेरी हार्टी कॉन्ग्रेचुलेशंस टू यू फॉर बीइंग अपॉइंटेड एज द चेयरमैन एंड मैनेजिंग डायरेक्टर ऑफ कॉटन कॉर्पोरेशन ऑफ इंडिया, दैट इज द CCI, विच इज द एपेक्स कॉटन बॉडी रिप्रेजेंटिंग द गवर्नमेंट इन इंडिया।
यस
Pradeep ji, with so much rich experience that you have brought with you, what is your vision for the next 3 years?
First of all, I am thankful to Ministry of Textile, Government of India, for appointing me as CMD of CCI to help the cotton farmers of the country. My paramount vision is that CCI should be popular as a friend to the cotton farmers on one hand. On the other hand, it should be popular amongst the mill as a dependable quality cotton supplier. This is my paramount vision.
Right. No, I am definitely aligned to that, that you have done that since so many years. But what extraordinary level can CCI reach under you? That was what is our expectation. So what is your vision?
The vision is that only the popularity should be like, perception should be like that. It is a helping hand. CCI is there. Main hu na concept. You have seen the Shah Rukh Khan movie, Main hu na. This is the concept I want that.
Correct.
CCI should be popular. The farmer
right.
should feel that CCI is there, no problem. That should be
right,
the approach.
See, that is very mental. And farmers have really, this year, especially 2019-20, the farmer have never felt like that before. They have felt a sense of belonging because CCI was always there to support them throughout the year. This was one of the biggest MSP years in India.
That is true.
Right. So, coming to our next question, is farmers, especially in Maharashtra, are having a good amount of unsold kapas. And CCI is the only buyer currently. So how does CCI plan to continue kapas purchase during the monsoon season?
Dagaji, you may be aware that as per CAB estimate, Maharashtra production is 82 lakh bales has been estimated by CAB. Out
Correct.
Of that, around 78 lakh bales kapas equivalent has come in the market. And if we go by the CAB estimate, only kapas equivalent to 4 lakh bales are yet to arrive in the market. I assure that CCI will be there till the last arrivals. By 30th September, we will be there in the market. I will ensure that the farmers are not put to distress. This time, even during lockdown period, we have purchased more than 6 lakh bales in Maharashtra. Not only CCI, we have appointed Maharashtra Federation as our agent. They have also done around 15 lakh bales along with CCI. So our procurement in Maharashtra state, out of 78 lakh bales, we have procured almost 41 lakh bales. 50% of the kapas arrival has been bought under MSP. It shows, the data shows that we have procured each and every bale of FAQ grade kapas. No farmer has been put to distress. Recently, I had a meeting with the Deputy CM, Ajit Pawarji, he was very happy that CCI has done a tremendous work for the farmers of Maharashtra. And we have bought kapas equivalent to 6,000 crores in Maharashtra.
Oh, wow.
6,000 crores. And our total procurement this time has been more than 27,000 crores across the country. Out of that, almost 25% is from Maharashtra only.
Right, right. Maharashtra has been the major contributor as far as the kapas supply has been, apart from Telangana, of course. So
After Telangana. Now we have crossed this 41 lakh figure is more than Telangana figure in Maharashtra.
Apart from Telangana, correct. So Maharashtra has been the prime supplier of kapas to CCI, or CCI has been the prime buyer for kapas in Maharashtra.
Correct.
And followed Telangana, and that is really good because the farmers were in deep distress where during
Correct.
The lockdown they did not know where to go.
Even
and
during
CCI
this rainy period also, we are there in the market. We are daily covering 40,000 to 50,000 quintals of kapas on day-to-day basis. The farmers
right.
are very happy this time in Maharashtra, and they are telling that had CCI not been there, we would have been exploited like anything.
No, no. The scenario is unimaginable. Agar CCI na hota is saal, to kya hota? Especially lockdown period mein. Agar Walji, to jitni badhai aapko di jaye, uske liye kam hai. To jis tarah CCI ne avirat support kiya hai किसानों को और जितना काम इन तीन महीना में हुआ है, मुझे नहीं लगता 10 साल में भी इतना सपोर्ट फार्मर्स को किसी और एजेंसी से मिला होगा।
दादा जी, I would like to mention here, I am very much thankful to my center in charges who had put their day and night. They have left their families. I have transferred from other states to Maharashtra to help the farmers of the state. Right. I have deployed around 30 people, 30 graders I have brought from other states, Telangana. Okay. Andhra Pradesh, many other states, Karnataka, they have come just leaving their family in lockdown period. They have come to a state to help the cotton farmers. So I am really grateful to all my center in charges and the entire team of branch. They have put all efforts to ensure that the farmers are not put to distress. This I am really thankful to them. They have done tremendous work.
No, it's a commendable job. We can call them the COVID fighters for the cotton and textile industry. So
they are the warriors, really the warriors.
Correct, correct. अच्छा अग्रवाल जी, अभी फिलहाल CCI के पास cotton bale में कितना stock है?
Dagaji, I would like to mention that this time CCI had made a record turnover of more than 1 crore bale, valuing 27,000 crores, as I mentioned earlier also. And it is the ever highest volumes handled by any single entity in the entire globe. Nobody has handled, single entity has not handled such a large volume. So this all credit goes to my graders, my field staff, my branch heads. They have put forth their all efforts, sleepless nights for this achievement. I am really thankful to them.
No, and two more people I would like to thank here. One is the management, that the CCI CMDs whose vision has given this empowerment to those people. And secondly, the ginners, those who have also cooperated to process the cotton during this difficult period. So,
and the current stock available with CCI is around 110 lakh bales.
Okay.
1.10 crore.
Okay, right. That is a very huge figure, Agarwal ji. So what are the three major steps that you wish to take to liquidate the stock? Because one side you have done an extremely good job of procurement, supporting the farmers and helping them when they really needed it the most. Now the industry part, the industry is looking up to you. How CCI is going to market this cotton?
Dagaji, as I mentioned that on one hand, CCI is there to help the farmers. On the other hand, we are there also to help the mill also as a dependable quality supplier. And this time, best quality has come to us.
Right.
You may appreciate that whatever, because we have paid the highest MSP rate.
Absolutely.
The best quality in the market was with CCI. And after taking over as CMD, I have already started close interaction with the mills as well as with the other buyers. And two major steps I have already taken.
Yeah.
One step, I have rationalized my discount scheme just 3 days back. On 15th, I declared my new scheme with the rationalized floor rate also. I have brought the floor rate in close proximity and parity with the markets. So that is a very good step CCI has taken to extend a helping hand to the textile mills, because this Indian cotton is the cheapest at this time. In the world, you can say it is the cheapest cotton. So I have brought my rates very close to the market. So it's a first major step I have taken. Second step is I have made my carrying charges rate very competitive. I have offered cash discount to the millers as well as a longer period for carrying longer large quantities from 30 days to 45 days. Because earlier the mills were getting only 30 days, I have extended that period up to 45 days.
Right.
So these two major steps I have already taken. And another step, as an alternate channel of export I am exploring, is in progress, is G2G arrangement, government to government agreement with the Bangladesh, Vietnam and other neighboring countries.
This,
because the surplus cotton is available in the country.
Right.
So unless there is an alternate channel, the stock cannot be liquidated in short span. So my right. focus is to make government-to-government G2G agreement with the neighboring countries so that bulk quantity can go at competitive prices. So is this because we need, you may be aware that the government has increased MSP for next year. So
right.
there are more chances of MSP next year also. So we need go down storage also. So right. for that, liquidation of the stock is the first and foremost priority for us. So that is why these steps I am taking to ensure that before the start of new season, at least space is available for further buying. Because if the godowns are full, then it will be a big hindrance for us to continue operation. My biggest challenge is to liquidate the stock, for which I am focusing.
I agree, and I should share with our viewers that Pradeep Kumar ji ne June 1 tarikh se jab se karobar sambhala hai CCI ke CMD ke roop mein Cotton Corporation of India ka 15 June ko hi unhone bahut hi aitihasik nirnay liya hai aur cotton prices practical physical market prices ke bahut close leke aaye CCI ke jo kafi mahino se बायस की कंप्लेंट थी कि बहुत ही आउटस्ट्रेच प्राइसेस हैं, इस प्राइस पे हम कैसे रुई खरीद सकते हैं, तो बहुत नज़दीक लेके आए हैं। प्लस एमएसएमई का जो बेनिफिट मिलना है इंडस्ट्री को वो भी मिलेगा, एमएसएमई का दायरा बड़ा है, अभी 250 करोड़ तक गया है, तो एमएसएमई के लिए डिस्काउंट अलग से है। प्लस इन्होंने लिफ्टिंग पीरियड भी बढ़ाया है, 30 दिन से बढ़ा के 45 दिन किया है। बहुत प्रैक्टिकल अप्रोच है और ये बहुत राइट स्टेप है कॉटन को मार्केट करने की दिशा में। दूसरा, अभी ये बता रहे हैं कि एक्सपोर्ट के लिए उन्होंने दूसरे देशों के की सरकारों से वार्तालाप शुरू किया है कि गवर्नमेंट टू गवर्नमेंट किस तरह मार्केटिंग हो सकता है, और ये होता है तो बल्क में होगा, बिकॉज जब सरकारों में बात होती है तो बल्क में होती है और इंडस्ट्री भी रिलाय करती है कि भाई सरकार के थ्रू काम हो रहा है, तो इसमें तो हमें शुभकामना ही आपको देनी चाहिए। प्रदीप जी के जल्द से जल्द आपकी कोई बड़ी डील क्लिक हो, आपका स्टॉक लिक्विडेट हो, आपके पास जगह बने, ताकि नेक्स्ट ईयर का एमएसपी परचेस अगर आता है तो फिर आपके पास भी जगह भी रहे और प्रोसेसिंग इंडस्ट्री के लिए भी स्पेस रहे उतनी। तो अब आते हैं मार्केट के ऊपर। प्रदीप जी, हाउ डू यू फोरसी द इंडियन एंड इंटरनेशनल कॉटन मार्केट इन द नेक्स्ट 3 months, बिकॉज वी हैव सीन इकोनॉमिक स्लो डाउन, वी हैव सीन कोविड, एंड देयर इज ऑल्सो अ लिक्विडेशन ऑफ स्टॉक विद द स्पिनिंग मिल्स। मोस्ट ऑफ द स्पिनिंग मिल्स अराउंड द वर्ल्ड डोंट हैव इनफ स्टॉक, and there are very few genuine suppliers in the market, and Indian cotton is now attractively priced. So we dono side of the coin hai aapke samne, aur aap itni badi post pe hain, to aap kya dekh rahe hain next 3 month mein cotton market ke liye?
Daga ji, what I am seeing that during lockdown period the mills were shut, so
right.
almost for 2 to 2.5 months there was a complete closure of consumption,
right?
The mills were not consuming any cotton. The stocks already covered was lying with them, but good thing is that after easing of the norms, now the mills have started working, and they are working at 70% level, and hope that it will improve gradually. Whatever inventory they were having, it started depleting now,
right.
And further, the kapas arrivals, which were in the range of 1.5 to 2 lakh bales. Now it is hardly 45,000-50,000 bales a day. Gradually it is reducing with the monsoon, onset of monsoon, it will further reduce. So I am quite hopeful that this will generate the demand amongst the mill, as well as global demand will also generate. So what current level, 34,000-35,000 level price, I foresee that in the coming months, it may reach again to the level of 37,000-40,000. This is my perception.
Right.
There will be at least 10% jump in the prices. As soon as the arrival will further go down, there will be a jump, and export will also start, because Indian cotton is the cheapest. The world is eyeing at Indian cotton. If the export movements are there, I am quite hopeful that the price will certainly improve at least by 10%. It may reach to the level of 40,000 rupees in the 3 months.
Okay. Right, so that would be a very good sign, because a revived market at the time of the new season is going to create a sense of optimism also, and that would reduce the pressure a little bit on the MSP operations also, because then the genus will also be willing to buy cotton for their private operations.
And one thing I would like to mention, the very astonishing fact has come that this time the seed rate again started rising. The seed rates which were ruling 2,200 rupees have again gone to 2,800 to 3,000 rupees.
Right. So the ginned seed rate have started rising, which is a good sign for the ginners for parity. It will be a good parity for those who are ginning the cotton.
Dadaji, can we take 1 minute pause? Because sure. The ministry is calling.
Are no problem at all. That call was meant to be taken. Comfortable now?
Yes.
Right. So coming to the market, Pradeepji Agarwal, CMD of Cotton Corporation of India, CCI, feels that the market is looking upbeat in the next 2-3 months. The demand is looking to come back, and if the demand comes back, the prices of cotton are expected to appreciate by about 10% in the next 3 months, that is just before the beginning of the new cotton season in September, October. Right, Pradeepji? So what opportunity that are available to India in terms of cotton and textiles, because we should also look at the value added items from cotton. If the mills are doing well, they would buy more, then they would export more cotton, yarn and fabric. So how are things, you know, what are the opportunities that we can tap here in the next 3 months?
Dadaji, as I told that Indian cotton is already the cheapest cotton available in the entire globe.
Right.
If you see Kotlu K index price, the cotton is ruling at 42,000 rupees minimum, average cotton of 118.
Right.
And Indian cotton prices is still available at 35,000-36,000 rupees. This is the cheapest cotton available.
Right.
So I am quite hopeful that the prices are bound to recover. They will improve. And export opportunities are ample because it is the cheapest cotton. Rupee is also favorable to dollar. So there is a good time to export cotton. And already 42 lakh bales have been exported within this period. And I hope that at least 10 to 15 lakh bales can go further. At least 10 lakh bales will go further.
Right.
So this will be a best opportunity for India to export cotton. And it will not only cotton, yarn is also very much demand in other countries.
Mm-hmm.
Vietnam, Bangladesh, they are waiting for Indian cotton. There is a good opportunity that Indian exporters may take advantage of the situation. And CCI is also in bigger talks with the neighboring countries, the export opportunities I am seeing is ample to the country.
Right. So both cotton and cotton yarn, you foresee that because of good demand overseas also, there might be a good pickup in the market.
Because of the advantage of geographical advantage is also there. With Bangladesh, we have the logistic advantage. The cotton reaches to their country within 7 days' time.
Right.
This is the biggest advantage available to us.
Right. So, Pradeepji, one or two questions that arise out of the industry. I am just asking impromptu, right? There has been an issue at the border, Indo-Bangla border, for the transshipment of cotton. So, if the CCI can intervene and the government can do something about that, that if the movement is faster, smoother, things can also.
Earlier, around some time back, it was there. Some congestion was there, but there are no reports right now that there is any problem at the border.
Right.
Because practically for last 2 months there was no movement. Earlier there was issues, but now I don't think there is any issue of border.
Right. So that has been sorted out.
That issue is not there right now.
Right. And regarding your discussion with the other government, you said they are already at an advanced stage. So how much volume do you foresee CCI can export in this?
I am expecting at least 10 to 15 lakh bales can go to Bangladesh.
Okay.
Because we are in talk for at least 1.5 million bales.
Okay. Hey, that would be a big jump. That would be more than, say about 12 to 15% of the total stock of CCI now. So if that quantity is moved at one go. So, Thank you, Pradeep ji. And it has been great talking to Shri Pradeep Kumar ji Agarwal, CCI, CMD. And he has just taken over the reins of the Apex Association of India, that is the Cotton Corporation of India, which is the government body representing purchase of kapas, that is seed cotton, and sale of cotton bills. So balancing both the farmers and industries, and they have played their role to the hilt since so many years, and this year especially, in the year of lockdown, in the year of COVID-19, in the year of so much difficulty and economic slowdown also, CCI has done historic purchase of cotton, seed cotton kapas, which has never happened before, crossing 10 million bales. That is really huge. And sir, we have shared our upcoming webinar series with you for the Cotton Guru Farmer Producer Company webinar. We are creating an e-platform for awareness and uplifting of smallholder farmers, as well as capacity building of the farmer producer companies. Your blessing has always been there with Cotton Guru. We know you since a very, very long time. So please share your views about the upcoming event.
Dagaji, I can say that this upcoming webinar of Cotton Guru is the best initiative and need of the hour. This type of webinar is the need of the hour, and this is very much commendable step you have taken. I can say that it has never happened in past, this type of webinar, particularly for the farmers.
Yes, there have been webinars, but they have been done by the city people, for the city people, and only city people have attended them.
But this is for the first time it is any webinar for the farmers. That is really a commendable job. And I am hopeful that this platform will provide active interaction with the experts and the farmers, so that best farm practices, timely advisories, transfer of technology from lab to field can happen with this platform.
Right.
And moreover, whatever feedback you will receive from the farmers, that will be very much useful for the scientists to improve their research. That because the farmers are the ultimate users of seed.
Correct.
Their feedback is very important. So through this platform, they will have the opportunity to give free and frank opinion about the quality of the seed or anything, research levels, advancement that can be improved. I am hopeful that farmers, scientists, and stakeholders will be immensely benefited with this webinar. And I congratulate Mr. Daga, you, who is the pillar of this Cotton Guru, I can say, for your innovative idea. And I wish you all the success for this platform of mass reach to the cotton farmer.
Thanks a lot. Your support has always been there. CCI has supported us during the Farmathon, also Cotton Guru's first ever farmers marathon in the world. And we have always been with CCI, and likewise. Thank you for a good wishes. Thank you for your support, and best wishes to you in your tenure as the Cotton Corporation of India, CMD. And I am sure, and we all of us are sure, that CCI will reach a new level under Shri Pradeep Kumar ji Agarwal. Thanks a lot.
All the best to you also. Thank you.
Thanks, Pradeep ji.